which used to be the Director of Medical Life Science in SNU, Department of Medical Science, Ministry of Public Health, and now she acts as the Assistant Director General, Department of Medical Science, Ministry of Public Health, Thailand. Please welcome Dr. Ankana Hiransavi to begin the presentation.
Ministry of Public Health since April this year.
So, come to the structure of DHSA. When we talk about the DHSA, the level should be in the four levels. The first one is the steering committee of DHSA. And this year, Indonesia become the chair of the steering committee, and next year will pass to Korea. And the DHSA, the second one, should be the lead countries of each package. That I have already said that they have the 11 package in the DHSA. So every package has the lead countries. And every package has a contributing country. Some will be the lead country, some will be the contributing country, and then there are the members of all of the country to be the member, and some will be the lead country of some package and become the contributing country, or the contributing country may become the lead country for some package, like Thailand lead for the ETIC 1, the National Laboratory System, and the ETIC 5, but we are the contributing country for the AMR. So that is the example of the how does we work with the DHSA. So as I told you that we already announced that we will be in DTEC 1 and DTEC 5, let me draw your attention to the DTEC 1 first. Again, as I have told before, the structure of the steering committee should be only one, that is Indonesia. We become the chair of the steering committee for this year. And for the DTEC 1, the National Laboratory System, the lead countries in this DTEC 1 have three countries. The first is the South Africa, and then Thailand, and the United States. But for this year, Thailand become the coordinating country for this year, and maybe next year to be the term of the South Africa. Last year, that is the United States. But for the contributing countries, for the DTEC 1, we have 14 countries in this group. That is the Canada, Colombia, China, Ethiopia, Finland, Georgia, Israel, Japan, Malaysia, Mexico, Peru, Switzerland, United Kingdom, and Yemen. And other countries can be the DHSA member for this group. In this year, Thailand takes turn to lead monthly video conference among the countries because, as I told you, that Thailand becomes the coordinating group of the leading group. So we lead the monthly video conference among the lead countries, and of course, sometimes the contributing countries will be further invited to join running the video conference if required. Like last time, Colombia asked to join the conference. And we set up the face-to-face meeting during that on was held on 28 July last month. Because this is the first time that it's face-to-face among the lead countries. Every month we have the video conference. So this time for 28 last month, that is the face-to-face for the lead country, and we invite the contributing country to join the meeting as well. So besides the DHSA membership, Thailand works closely with working level support team in providing secretariat function for this year. What is the support team that I will explain later? So this is the example of the monthly video conference that we make the video conference in Department of Medical Science and here that is from the United States. And this one that we form the WHO. So this is our Director General. This is from the WHO as well. So the highlight of the DTEC 1, that is the first one, is the key milestone and the activities in 2016.
And the second one is the partnership, collaboration, and outreach for 2016. Birth, key challenges on laboratory, and fourth, Thailand's leading role that we organized a regional workshop last month. And we already developed a regional strategic roadmap on laboratory system strengthening and the roadmap that is used for this year until 2020. And of course, besides the roadmap just the roadmap, the important is to implementation. And we already led an implementation of key regional activities of this year and the next year. For the key milestone activity in 2016 is this year. Thailand already set up the workshop enhancing regional partnership towards strengthening laboratory system in accelerating GHSA implementation, DTEC 1. That's what convened last month in Bangkok. Aims to, among other, to identify key regional activities and implementing mechanisms and to enhance networking on laboratory across region. This is important. Otherwise, we have a meeting every year, but just meeting, just talking, just no acting. That is important that we don't like to have that one with the DTEC 1, especially this year that we set up some of the roadmap so that every country can go and working with the GHSA to their home country. And of course, as I have mentioned before, we have a half day of face-to-face meeting of the countries, that is the United States, South Africa, and Thailand, and contribute countries that join this meeting. So this is aimed to stimulate discussion and accelerating and implementation and talking about the collaboration or identifying of the regional activities. So it come to the successful of the collaboration among the lead country and the coordinating country, even in the region, or even some talking about it, just not only for the regional, the country, the lead country should have the collaboration as well and working something, not only meeting. So that is the point. And the regional workshop in November, that the date will be confirmed later. That is another thing to fostering sharing practice and tools to enhance an implementation of the DTEC 1, the National Laboratory System. And of course, another thing is important for the laboratory, that is to promote utilization of joint external evaluation or JEE. This is the JEE is the thing that WHO and GHSA have the same aims to enhance the capacity of the laboratory system. And Thailand requests the collaboration of the WHO to materialize an implementation of JEE. So that is why when we make the monthly video conference, we ask the WHO to join us in the conference to advise for the JEE and plan for the JEE evaluation, not only in the Thailand, but also the regional country that is in this one, including the ASEAN. So that's why, of course, we collaborate with ASEAN trusting laboratory network and other relevant regional platform on the laboratory. And we invite SAKU and ASEAN, including Timor-Leste, to participate in two regional workshops, that is last month and then in the next November. The collaboration with the key development partner organized already started. So this is the last month that we held the regional workshop enhancing regional partnership towards training laboratory system in accelerating THSA implementation in Taiwan. So this is the participant from the country that are the participant from many countries who join us. And this is opening ceremony by our Director General on this workshop. The objectives of last month's workshop, that is the first one, is to update on national strategic plans on national laboratory system training. So, and in last month, every country had to present the national strategic plan, what they have done about the THSA in their country. And the second objective is to present the regional strategic roadmap on laboratory system based on the output from May 2015 meeting. So it means that in May 2015 meeting, they already set up some components that should be goals or something. But after that, everyone go back and nothing to do. So this time we start to do the regional strategic plan roadmap. Another thing is to propose the key regional activities and identify implementing mechanisms. So it means that after the roadmap, we already start up for the activities of that roadmap and also identify implementing mechanisms. And the last one, that is to enhance networking on LHS across the region. The important thing that maybe everyone know that when we talk about the THSA, everyone say that should be one health. It means the human health and animal health should be in collaborate. During 3 days of our workshop, the first day we achieved the update of THSA in Taiwan and the roadmap, and we already discussed for the key regional activities. And for the second one, the output of the meeting was identify the key regional activities and operationalization and talking about the JEE by WHO that joined our workshop. And we have already summary and made the recommendation. And for the last day, we update on the real time of biosurveillance and upcoming the regional activities and networking. But because now the important one thing is that talking about the biosurveillance and the biosecurity, bio risk management in each country have to aware of this work. The participants during our workshop, we separate in the group of ASEAN, that is Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, Malaysia, Myanmar, Thailand, and Vietnam. And the SAR group, that is Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Nepal, and Timor-Leste. And for the RE countries, for the Taiwan, the United States, South Africa, and Thailand. And we have the contributing countries join us. As I have mentioned before, that we have 14 of the contributing countries in Taiwan. And this time, we got 6 of the countries who joined. This time, this is Georgia, Japan, Malaysia, Canada, Yemen, and Switzerland. Besides the participants like that, we have the European partner and the local partner as well. The one is the ASEAN Partnership Laboratory that is for Malaysia as well. And we ask the animal health that to join us so that we can talk about the One Health together. We have the FAO, USAID, Thai US CDC, WHO from Zero and Vibro, OIP, and MECO Basic Disease Surveillance join us as well. The APA, JICA, AFI, Ministry of Public Health, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and we have a guest of honor to join this workshop. So this is a press release activities. After we have the face-to-face meeting among the leading countries and contribute countries. And then the pace of this activity already have done, and maybe some of you already seen from the newspaper or even from the TV news, watching from the TV news. The results of the workshop already identify the key challenges of our national laboratory. And we got the strategic roadmap or laboratory strengthening system and identify the key regional activities. From the participating country, 13 countries already challenged the legislative frameworks, increased the diagnostic capacity such as biobanking and bioinformatics. We talk about the bioinformatics among the countries, and everyone agree that the bioinformatics is very important so that we can share among the country, especially when we have faced with the emerging disease or the some pathogen, the dangerous pathogen like Ebola or the MERS, COVID. Then another thing that we agree to establishment of the EQA or External Quality Assurance System and accreditation, so that every country will have the same level or we can go together of the strengthening of the laboratory of the country. And of course, we already set up for the monitoring and maintain service for biomedical engineering, like a biosafety cabinet. Since Thailand already have the expert that can be the trainer, so that we can set up and support for other countries to learn about the maintenance of the biomedical engineering. And we already set up establishment of the regional database for sharing information. Like Thailand say that we have the influenza bioinformation. And Malaysia say that they have the dengue like this. So we agree to establish the regional database together. Another thing is that is very important to achieve in one health. It means that should be the linking information between the human and animal health sector. And of course, another thing is to shortage of the laboratory workforce. Let me draw your attention to the regional strategic roadmap on laboratory system strengthening, start from this year until 2020. The background is that led by the three lead countries, including the USA, Thailand, and South Africa, that aims to strive for the real-time biosurveillance with national laboratory system and effective modern point of care and laboratory-based diagnostic. So after that, drafted by Thailand, since we are the coordinating country, the country in this year. So we start to draft the strategic roadmap on the laboratory system, and then we discuss among the countries during the video conference. And after that, we have already made the core component and cross-cutting component. And after we distribute the roadmap to the countries, and to the other contributing countries to put input the we would like to in have the input for each country that they can follow that regional roadmap or not. So we come to this regional strategic roadmap or laboratory system or DTEC1. The goal is the real-time low surveillance with national laboratory system and effective modern point of care and laboratory-based diagnosis. The component, we have the core component, four core components, and the three cross-cutting components. These components already set up since May 2015 last year. And as I told you that after meeting, everyone go back and they don't know how to start or how to collaborate. Everyone work by their own style. So this time we made the strategic components and set the core component for the four one. The first one is the strategic policy and registering and licensing and diagnostic capacity and the quality management system and biorisk management system. So this is the core component for the ETEC one that we think this is important. And we have the cost cutting from the networking, one health and laboratory workforce. And each core component already set up the objectives. That is the first one, like an entry plan of policy addressing. So everyone can take this regional roadmap to follow this one. And then for the diagnostic capacity, the strengthening the objectives is the strengthening diagnostic capacity for outbreak of the emerging disease. We already set up 10 of disease like measles, malaria, HIV, influenza. That is the important, or Ebola, MERS-CoV, that is the important disease, the dangerous disease. And besides that already set up for the 10 disease, every country can set up by themselves because every country have their own circumstance and their own problem about the pathogen, the dangerous pathogen, so they can set up by themselves. And for the quality management system, which is important for the laboratory, should have the quality. Otherwise, we cannot make sure that the quality of the laboratory is not the same. So maybe we don't know that the results of the laboratory is realizable or not. So we established, and then we found that every country have their laboratory, but the level of the quality is not the same. So we established an enhancing statewide, and of course, to make the proficiency of the laboratory among the country. We think about the EQA, or External Quality Assurance and Accreditation Program for each country. For the biorisk management system, this is another thing that since now the dangerous pathogen is quite dangerous, and everyone aware of the pathogen like this. So we think every country should enhance the capacity building of the biorisk management system, so that everyone can make sure to handle of the dangerous pathogen. For the cross-cutting component, we're talking about the networking, so that we have to enhance the inter or the regional health-related networks. As I told you that we have the three countries, the United States, South Africa, and Thailand as the lead country for the ETEC one laboratory system strengthening. So the regional that we are talking, like in Thailand, it is not only the ASEAN, but we have to the regional take care with other countries like Timor-Leste or like other country that is in the Asia Pacific like that. So that is in the regional. And when we start to do something, some of other regional, like Colombia is not in the same regional with Thailand, interested in our activity, so maybe cost to the inter-regional as well. Another thing is the One Health. This is important that One Health is talking. We are talking about the One Health that should be among the zoonotic disease. well, for the human and for the animal as well. And the laboratory workforce that is training for the laboratory workforce. So the joint collaborative effort of the countries of GSSA that aim to provide the general guidance for GSSA member countries in Europe, their respective national roadmap. The national roadmap of each country should be the same or get along with the regional roadmap so that we identify the key strategic components in intent to reinforce the IH 2005 as well as other relevant regional strategy like Asia Pacific strategy for emerging disease or access. And not in different stage of national laboratory context, the roadmap will be further modified to be suitable for local circumstances. And the roadmap serves as a tool framework for follow-up progress of the GHSA ETIC 1 system and serve as the framework identification of regional activities and can be consideration of synergized effort needs among GHSA group and the package like with the zoonosis. One thing that we have to contribute that is the JEE or Joint External Evaluation involving a combination of domestic and independent experts that will be promoted as monitoring and evaluation tools. The real-time biosurveillance with a national laboratory system and effective modern point of care and laboratory-based diagnostic is another thing that become the important for topic for GHSA ETIC 1. As I told you, that key components of the roadmap was agreed since May 2015 last year among the participating countries of the meeting and served as the basic formulation of this important document. So we just take the key components from May 2015 and draft by Thailand to propose. And of course, these key development partners, including WHO and UNICEF, have already made a video conference with us and agree to have this regional roadmap. The regional activities will be proposed by any of the lead country or any contributing country as well. And the implementing modalities will be proposed, collaborate with WHO, FAO, OIE, and other regional organizations as well. For the action plan of the key regional activities, we already set up the roadmap. And then next from the roadmap should be the activities, how to go, go and have the activity go to the to have the output or to reach the outcome of the roadmap. The Department of Medical Science holds a meeting key development partners on 19 August, just a few days ago, to draft the action plan. And this draft action plan will be further consulted with lead countries in the next video conference that already scheduled on 21st September. From the workshop, the regional activities have already identified. The first one, activity to go to the regional roadmap, that is the bioengineering training. So the lead country that already set up should be Thailand. And we think we will train in next year. And the key partner for support, for the budget support, like US, CDC, EFRIN, or FAO, and UNICEF. Because this bioengineering training not only train for the human laboratory, but also for the animal laboratory as well to get the one health. The second one is the EQA, or External Quality Assurance Program. The lead country is South Africa and Thailand. South Africa offers to be the lead in EQA, because South Africa say that they have the experience about the dangerous pathogen like Ebola in South Africa, so that they can share the experience for the EQA, take the pathogen disease through the country to have the laboratory system at the same. And of course, the key partner should be the Thailand and USCDC, FAO, and USAID as well. And then sharing experience on lab preparedness, lesson learned from EID outbreak. This is for Thailand and South Africa as well, because South Africa, as a whole, they have the experience. And from Thailand, during this year, we already set up for the DRA or designated receiving area. So normally in the hospital, when the patients come and have to check for the disease, the laboratory have the same laboratory. They don't aware about the dangerous pathogen. So after we have a problem with Ebola or MERS COVID, so we start to set up the designated receiving area or the laboratory that can be separate for just only for the dangerous pathogen in the hospital. We success to have the DRA in the hospital in our country. Not every hospital, but mostly in whole country, we have the DRA laboratory in the hospital. And this hospital that we support to have the DRA in each of the region of the country. And the key partner of this one should be the USAID, FAO, and the WHO as well. And another thing is the bioinformatics network. As I have told before, that Thailand already set up the bioinformatics for the influenza, and Malaysia support for the dengue. So we are start to build the bioinformatics. And then we training for the influenza bioinformatics as well. And have the regional workshop to share for the linking experience in implementing countries like Indonesia and Vietnam. To join about the public health and animal health. And the quality assurance supply chain management like Thailand, Sri Lanka, and Indonesia. So this one we have already planned to have this activity and should be submitted to the video conference with the other countries in the next video conference. So development of the regional, this one, another thing that is important, that is the development of regional agreement for material transfer. That is the referral system. So in Indonesia and Thailand, will go further for the bilateral for the MTA, because the referral system is quite important, especially for the dangerous pathogen. And we will start to have the referral lab network for Malaysia, Indonesia, and Sri Lanka, and training stepwise for laboratory development towards the national accreditation. So GHSA is an enable platform to leverage and maximize the existing efforts from countries and partners, and have the communication between public health and animal health, and coordination with the other partnership like the WHO, FAO, and avoid duplication. And then we have the networking for the networks. So the way forward is to enhance collaboration and accelerate the political commitment of the stakeholder, engagement collaboration of animal and human health sector, and enhancing integrate the networks like a lab or field of epidemiology network, and accelerate the national implementation of each country and interface with other package of DHSA. Another role of Thailand is the leading in DTEC 5 of workforce development. The DTEC 5, that is workforce development, the leading country have two countries, that is Jordan and Thailand. And the contribute country is Ethiopia, Finland, Saudi Arabia, United States, and Yemen. And the highlight of this one, that is already achieved since May 2015, that the meeting step towards regional strategic collaboration in Asia-Pacific on workforce development, national laboratory system, antimicrobial resistance, and prevention to respond to global challenges, that already conducted in Bangkok, Thailand, since last year, and they have 29 countries participate in this one. And the initial roadmap of GSHA 45 already formulated. And this year, the workshop on regional strategic framework for human health workforce development on epidemiology, advanced IHR and GSSA held in Yogyakarta, Indonesia. And the participants already joined to use the participate approach in a small group with the ASEAN Plus 3 FETN steering committee and the DAC for finalized. And GHSA for the DTEC 5 focal person in 10 countries were nominated in that meeting. And the joint meeting between ASEAN Plus 3 Field Epidemiology Training Network and ASEAN Veterinary Epidemiology Group, again, that is joint between the public health and animal health together, was organized to strengthen collaboration between public health and animal health, that is already a few days ago in Da Nang, Vietnam. So this course, the training of the introductory course of international FETP, Thailand will already conduct, and we already start to have the training for the trainer of cohort study to have the workforce development. And the next key milestone activity is that the regional strategic framework of the workforce development system was shared among the participating countries, and workforce of the Tech 5 and the Tech 1 meeting will be joined early in December. So, and work plan for the next 3 years will be developed for the workforce development. And the regular communication by quarterly of the video conference have already done for DTEC 5 as well. So this is the draft GSA roadmap for action or action package ongoing in the 8 or 11 package ADA. And during this day, they have the GSA meeting in Jakarta, Indonesia to share about the lesson learned about the working of the GSA of each country of the member. And then this is the guideline, again, the guideline and the best practice for the workforce development should be set up. And of course, ASEAN Plus 3 already developed several tools for the FETP training and the exercise of the case study or the tabletop exercise. And the guideline of the joint outbreak investigation is in preparation as well, or the training with the veterinary and medical epidemiology using One Health approach has improved to the coordination sharing resource network. The partnership that should be One Health, again, One Health partnership, and the ASEAN Plus 3 from the human and the animal side. The collaboration should be in the program, and the bilateral collaboration between the country on technical exchange, but of the border health issue is another important issue of the workforce development. So important thing is that the four-way linking from the Tech 1 and the Tech 5 for Thailand is an exciting opportunity. Since the Tech 1 is in the Department of Medical Science, and the Tech 5, the core is in the Department of Disease Control. So the one thing is that we have to joint collaboration between these two detail groups. That is the important. Another thing important is the commitment of financing of IHR 2005 with the JEE that is already supported by GHSA. So this is the end of my talk. Thank you.
Development, Macdonald University, and the organizing committee, I'd like to thank Professor, Dr. Ankana Hiranasali for her excellent presentation, which very important and extremely important to the audience about the global health.